Okay, everyone, I think we can start now. First of all, I would like to welcome you to the Fit for RI webinar about institutional change towards more RI and open science. My name is Helene Brinken and I work at the State and University Library in Göttingen and lead communications in Fit for RI. And I will be moderating this webinar today. And yeah, I would like to start with some housekeeping. So yeah, it would be great if you mute yourself when you're not speaking. And if you have any questions during the presentations, you can just type them into the chat. And we will record this webinar, so the recordings, but also the slides will be available on our website and also on our YouTube channel. So we will share the link with everyone who registered. We'll also tweet, of course, and share the links via our social media channels. So first of all, I would like to introduce our speakers today. So we have Adrian Solomon, who is project manager at the Southeast European Research Center in Greece. And he will talk about the methodology of the co-creation experiments we conducted. Afterwards, we will have Raquel Almeida, who is senior project manager at the Training and Qualifications Unit in the Research and Development Department of ICQ in Portugal. And she will talk about how they engaged internal stakeholders from their private company to build and develop an institutional RI model. And our third speaker will be Mary Jane Monaghan, who is a research assistant at the School of Electric Engineering and Electronics at the University of Liverpool in UK. And she will talk about how they engaged internal stakeholders such as university staff and also external stakeholders such as SMEs to understand how to better embed RI and ethics as well as science education into research study and innovation development. Before we come to these presentations, I would like to give you a short introduction into the project and also a definition of what we mean when we talk about responsible research and innovation. So as we all know, science and technology can create risk and ethical dilemmas. So responsible research and innovation seeks to bring research and innovation into the open so that we can anticipate the consequences and also involve the society. Societal actors, such as researchers, citizens, policymakers, business or NGOs, work together during the research and innovation process so that we can better align the products, the process and the outcomes with the values of the society as well as the needs and the expectations. So in short, we can maybe say that it means to involve all stakeholders at all levels so that we can minimize the potential negative impact. So this webinar is conducted in the frame of Fit for RI, and this project is a three-year project, and we work with 12 partners from 9 countries, and we move from the assumption that RI as well as open science could and should play a much bigger role in research funding and performance organization than they currently do. And what we do to approach this issue is we work on two key factors. So we develop training and recommendations for government settings to activate institutional change. And our context and approach is that we have three strands. So the first step was to understand why RI and open science are not implemented as much as we wish they would be. So we analyze the trends, barriers, drivers, and interest. Then we had a testing phase. So we conducted three co-creation experiments to observe RI and open science in action, and these will be the topic today. And the third step will be to promote our results and to develop the training tools and guidelines. I just want to say that we already had some webinars, and so about these first steps of this understanding RI, so about the sectorial analysis and the mapping and benchmarking we did. So you can click on the links as soon as you have the slides. And I just want to mention that our training materials are available at fosteropenscience.eu. So there are the upcoming events, such as the webinar today, but also an RI and Open Science Trainer Bootcamp, which will be organized soon, and our resources. And now I would like to hand over to Adrian, who will give a short introduction into
Thank you very much, Helen, for this great introduction on the project and on this webinar.